Today we are going to talk about prosperity. I know that this is something that everybody wants to achieve, and our never-ending need and desire for expansion includes prosperity, because here in three-dimensional material world, we do need to satisfy our needs in order to be happy on a physical level, and then the spiritual level joins the physical. If we only work with the spiritual level, the body suffers. So today, I'm going to share my process with this painting. It actually started a little crazy because I was working in my prosperity field. And the painting I was creating for myself was really brutal, with all the oranges and blues and explosions. Then a client of mine looked at it and said, I want this painting. So let me show you the painting. So I said, well, I'm not selling my painting because it's in the process, but I will do something for you. Would you like to have something for you? And he said, sure. And I wanted as bold as yours. This is not a painting. This is just the other painting. And I like to put layers in my paintings because as I develop painting, thoughts and ideas come into my mind. And so I put them in and I write them down and I cover it with another layer and another layer and another layer. So as I developed that painting that I was doing for my client, out of the craziness and splashes came the tree. And this is the tree, the money tree, the tree of prosperity, with the spirals of life coming out of it and opening into the universe to receive the leaves. Because through the leaves we inhale, we breathe, the earth breathes through the leaves of the green trees. And for some reason, we always think about money tree being a tree with green on it. The stars are abundant, and the stars are the nurturing substance for our expansion and prosperity. And when I talk about prosperity, it's never about just the money, because money is the end result of the creative process that we engage in collaborations and on our own. I truly believe everything is collaboration because, like I said, the stars are abound and also in my life. And so Alexandra is one of those stars. And as those stars come into connection, we shine the light upon each other and new things are happening. And so as I was progressing with the painting, the earth in which this cosmic ability to connect with the stars and blossom within the universal flow rooted itself into the earth and start bringing the star quality, the star dust, the glow into the earth, and the roots, golden roots, hug the earth. So all the wonderful, amazing ideas that come from our universal mind can come to the earth and bring the prosperity for everybody, not just for one individual, because we are always about sharing. And then the bud starts growing, the flowering starts growing, and the three layers of prayer came out of it. So those prayers are about connecting to the self, to those you protect within yourself, and those who protect you. So we're always working in the structures in which we are mentoring somebody, but somebody is mentoring and leading us. And these layers of guidance are never stopping, because as we grow, we can include more and more of those who we nurture and grow within us, within our circles of connection. And also, as we grow, we get into bigger and bigger sandboxes of the universe. And so bigger and bigger beings include us. For example, we are included in intentional creativity, which is a huge, great community of wonderful people. And within that community, Maestra Shaila Sophia, for example, is my mentor. But as I grow, I also include Shaila Sophia in my prayers, and I contribute my ideas, my cosmic inspirations into her work. And so we can consistently, constantly interact through the spirals of life, emanating through the field of intentional creativity, the intentions for that which we want to create next. And when I finished the painting, I looked at it and I said, this is a wonderful painting. This is amazing painting. And it's a very powerful painting, but it's definitely not for the man who ordered it. because I've developed it to the point where it became extremely feminine, or at least my brutal beginning was softened through the bath and glow of the universal connection with the star destiny that we have. I looked at that painting and I decided to come back to the beginning. And here I am again. So this is the same person working on the creative prosperity painting, and that's where the first painting started, but not with the same scheme, of course. And this one is about growing the bud with your own hands and being able to mentor and be on target with the friendship and empowerment, creating the celebration of life. So what would your painting be if you would spend a little time, even with your markers, with the paper or canvas? Would you take that challenge?
Thank you for sharing your journey and the process. And the one point I want to make in conclusion is that part of the prosperity flow is exactly like what your process is demonstrating, is allowing the flow to take us into the direction that is seeking to emerge, rather than complaining that there is no flow because it's not taking us where we would like it to go, instead of recognizing that the flow is always available to us and aligning ourselves with where it is directing us, and gratefully receiving and working with what is available and being prepared to be surprised.
And therefore, bravely step into the universe of creation. There are stars that will illuminate the way. Just allow.